Hello and welcome to my series of A Link Between Two Worlds. This entire playthrough, whatever you want to call it, will be focused on a 100% guide of A Link Between Two Worlds. So that means every side quest, every heart piece, every AM, every dungeon, every anything to do in the game. Everything will be covered throughout the series, so if you're looking for that sort of playthrough, then you have stumbled upon one that is dedicated to do so. So without further ado, let's jump into the game. That's really nostalgic. The Link to the Past theme here is pretty much the most pinnacle point of the series, where the series became something that was really memorable. A Link to the Past kind of set a formula for the rest of the Zelda series. I have a fail here because I tried to record earlier and I picked the wrong codec when I went to record, so yeah, I had a failed recording. But we're gonna go ahead and begin our fail here. I normally name my character Link because the default name it actually is the character's name. I don't rename it to anything else normally, so we're just gonna leave it how it is and begin the game. So being introduced to this Link, we know he's a blacksmith already, or wants to be one. Picking up pots and stuff is done with the A button in this game. And Link and Majora's Mask, you can only save through the Ella statues. Well, in MM, you could play this on time to save also. But if you wanted to save, like, anywhere in the overworld without going back to the first day, you had to save it in an Ella statue. And this game kind of follows that tradition by forcing us to use these Ella statues rather than local saving. Ella statues? The weather vanes. My bad, sorry, I was talking about Majora's Mask. And from here, we're going to go ahead and go to the blacksmiths. As you can see, where Gully is going, that's where we're supposed to be going also. So we're just going to go ahead and jump down and follow him. Gully went this way. By pressing the A button, Link does this kind of weird crouch, like he's going to pick something up. We can't run yet because we don't have like the Pegasus boots or anything. For those of you that are familiar with Link to the Past, that's how you move quickly in this game. So we get a sword now. From what I had played when the failed recording happened, you don't have control over the sword yet. So the game kind of does help you a little bit, for those of you that were wondering about the hand-holding stuff. It doesn't, like, hold your hand to the point where it will directly tell you where to go by moving the camera. It just places an X on your map, which is fine. For those of you that have never played The Link to the Past, you wouldn't know where to go to get to the castle without the overworld map. So, let's just go ahead and talk to him. Then over here, and take a left. Then we can head up here into this direction. The sanctuary is always been behind the castle, but the overworld is slightly different to that of Link to the Past, so you may not be familiar with it. We're about to encounter a very familiar face for those of you that played Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask.
Hi.
It's Dampy the Gravekeeper. My knowledge of this series is very vast, so like anticipate a lot of noticed references that I'll be pointing out throughout the series. We have two options, but if you want to get through it quickly, just say what sword, and okay. So now that we've went ahead and did that, we can actually use the sword in combat. And now you can use it to defeat enemies and also cut down things. This, area here will lead to the underground part of the sanctuary. It's not the same as Link to the Past, so don't be thinking it is. And instead of here, we have the lamp. We can equip it with a touchscreen. Now, for those of you that are wondering how this is done, you can go ahead and click items, and then when you click on the item itself, you can either drag it, or you can go ahead and press the button. I prefer to press the button, because dragging it is a pain. But it's intuitive for both ways, for those of you that will feel so inclined to do so. Controlling Link, for those of you that are wondering or maybe skeptical after the games like Phantom Hourglass and Spirit Tracks, controlling Link is done through that of the circle pad. It is not done through the touchscreen at all, so don't worry like about really crappy controlling Link, because it seems pretty good so far from what I've played, which is like a little over 20 minutes or so when that failed recording. Really wish that the capture program had a way of telling you when a recording was going to fail, but it doesn't. So the red rupee here will actually help to buy things later in the game. For those of you that don't know already, the equipment stuff, apart from like the lantern that we just got, is not normally found in dungeons. You have to rent it from Ravio or buy it from Ravio. Ravio is a character that we're going to be meeting fairly soon, I guess. I didn't mean to take damage there, but whatever. Damage in this game is not quarter hearts by the look of it. It's like more half hearts to full hearts to maybe even double hearts. Very traditional to Link to the Past. The Link to the Past is the most damage dealing Zelda game that has existed in the last 20 years. In this room, you just have to defeat a bunch of Poes. I think that's all of them. Yeah, it is. Then, in this room here, on the left, on the link Link to the Past, you can open up the door. A Link to the Past used the right hand side of this room, or a room similar to this, to progress forward. Whereas in this game, it's the left hand. So this is Ravio. He's the guy that's gonna sell all the items to us at some point in the game. Since he's going to be giving us all the items, of course we're going to let him stay. A lot of people speculate that this guy is a reference to Link and a Link to the Past. But I honestly don't know yet. Okay, so just to satisfy everybody, there's the Majora's Mask. It's just on the wall, you can't do anything with it, but I'm guessing there's more references to what Anoma meant and say to the game itself. So yeah, we're just gonna go ahead and leave. Goodbye, Ravio, you very strange character. And we're gonna go ahead and save the game here and call this a video since this is where I left off in the failed recording. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you haven't already, you can click the annotations on the screen. Preferably click the subscribe one first if you want to follow this series and also follow my content. I'll be doing a complete 100% playthrough of this game, showing absolutely everything, every side quest, everything to do with the game. So feel free to hit subscribe in that little annotation there, or in the description, I guess. And I'll see you guys in the next episode of A Link Between Two Worlds. Thank you very much for watching.